Hi everyone, I'm Prateek, and welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to be looking at the Kennedy classification, which is an extremely common way that we classify partial dentures. For those of you who haven't already, please check out my book, Single Best Answer Questions for Dentistry. This book covers a range of topics in dentistry and provides you with over 280 questions to help you practice. I'll put all the links in the description. So let's talk about the Kennedy classification. This was developed by Dr. Edward Kennedy, and it is the most common method that we use to classify partial dentures. The classification system is based upon the most common partially dentate cases that we see. So if we look at class 1, Kennedy class 1 describes a bilateral free end saddle case. So if we break this down, firstly, what is a saddle? A saddle refers to the edentulous space that we're going to fill with the denture, so the area on the ridge that the denture is going to take up. The term free end refers to the way the saddle will be sat. So this refers to the fact that the saddle will only have teeth abutting on one side and the other side is going to be free, i.e. free-ended. Kennedy class 2 describes a unilateral free end saddle. So the same type of saddle, but only on one side of the mouth. Kennedy class 3 describes a unilateral posterior bounded saddle. Now, a bounded saddle is different to a free end saddle in the fact that you have teeth either side of the saddle. So there are teeth abutting on either side of the saddle. These tend to be slightly better tolerated compared to Kennedy class 1 and 2, and they're usually more secure for the patient. And finally, we have Kennedy class 4. Now, Kennedy class 4 describes an anterior bounded saddle. This is the least common case that we would see. However, it's very rare that we see a patient who only has one edentulous space, and therefore we can add modifications to the Kennedy classes. And this can be done for Kennedy class 1, 2, and 3. So the way the modifications work is we take the most posterior edentulous space, and this will define the Kennedy class, and then the number of other edentulous spaces becomes the modification. The reason we don't have modifications for Kennedy class 4 are that if we had any other edentulous spaces, they're going to be more posterior, and therefore they would fall into one of the other Kennedy classes. Therefore, you cannot have modifications with the Kennedy class 4. If we now look at some examples, here we have a Kennedy class 1 modification 2, and this is because we've got a bilateral free end saddle case, and then we have two other edentulous spaces, hence the modification 2. Alternatively, if we look at this example, we have a Kennedy class 3 modification 1. This is a prime example of where you have an anterior edentulous space that ends up being classified as something else because you have posterior edentulous space that falls under another Kennedy classification. So we have Kennedy class 3, a unilateral bounded saddle, modification 1, because we have that other edentulous space anteriorly. So there we've gone through the Kennedy classification and the modification system for it. So I hope you found this video useful. My recommendation in this video is a Tooth Germ, which is a dental blog run by Natalie Bradley. Now, amongst many things, Natalie works in special care dentistry. However, her blog covers a wide variety of dental topics and has contributions by other dental colleagues. Be sure to check it out. If you did find this video useful, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Until the next video, take care.